first in yards, first in passing, dead last in mostly anything defense. Makes sense. Not dead last in rushing anymore. That's pretty good. I've worked my way out of the 126th position in rushing.
Glad to have you with us in the studio.
Oh, and it's in the snow.
Bringing you the EA Sports NCAA football.
Things are about to get interesting. I'm going to be having some wide receivers slipping and sliding all over the damn place.
The fans come alive as the players take the field at Mountaineer Field in Morgantown, West Virginia.
All right. Yeah, I'll do the return because we'll be going into the field to kick this one off.
Everyone in the stadium is ready for this game to get started. He'll take it from the two.
Hey, look at this. Oh, damn.
And he's tackled.
Start getting excited there.
Probably think it seems like
you also are about 15 minutes later than what was set to be one of the biggest screw jobs in gaming. I try to highlight it on my YouTube. Holy crap. Try to highlight on my YouTube tonight and have it up there because it's for me it's a highlight of just going nuts on what I call the Kennedy assassination conspiracy, magic bullet style magic football, where I was facing Kansas and they caught an interception for a ball that was on its way down, and then wow. It was on its way down, and then just before it hit the ground, it got magically sucked into the guy's hands. Thankfully, we won. Otherwise, I'd probably have frisbeed the game disc.
He's rolling right. He chucks it down.
Oh, please, thank you.
That's a great tackle at the 37.
It definitely put them in better field position, and I just have a feeling that they're going to punch it into the end zone on this drive.
Yep.
And the big pickup through the air is made.
Let's see how Diesel Dan does. We had one go not so well. I think this one might go better. Yep.
Brought down at about the 29-yard line.
He just kind of ripped me down by my helmet there, it looked like.
That makes it second and two.
Maybe not quite face masking, but like on the sides of the helmet. I got stuck.
It's never good for a back's confidence.
I got stuck.
For a loss. But this guy knows that he's got to just keep at it, and the holes will start to open up.
And here's another screen. Third down.
Great. And these fans are rowdy.
Tosses out to the tailback on the screen. And down he goes at the 20-yard line.
I'm not sure if the back was his first option.
Yeah, I think he just kicked him in the nuts. I think he just sort of left his foot there and was just like, yeah, I'm going to keep this foot right here in your nuts. Feel the bottom of my cleat.
Gets to about the 17-yard line.
It also looked pretty nice to have the all white Cyclones.
Second down, 7 yards to go.
Wearing that all white and snow. There we go. That's what I'm thinking. That's what I was looking for in some of my guys. Just running dudes over. That was the whole last game, basically, was my main running back.
This is the ninth play.
Just running guys over. This is not him. This guy's good too.
Dives for extra yardage.
You know that saying, get your keys out, because we're on a drive? This offense right now is on a drive. I mean, this is their third first down.
Tell me this Diesel Dan.
They're doing just about anything they want.
All right.
And they're really
Diesel Dan's going
to
punch this one in.
Wear the psyche of this defense down.
They're crowding the line.
Oh, they caught him. Ah, he still got it. Touchdown technicality.
That was a very good all-around effort. Running, the blocking, the entire package. A well-deserved score.
Change of possession. Change of possession. And they punched it in as well. Oh, well. Throw ball, catch ball, tech. This is your national sport.
Every drive's important in a tie game. I look for both sides to come out
with
some
What country are you from? I never really thought about that. Obviously not from America, but yeah, this is kind of the big national sport. I did see, oh God, what is it? Stephen Fry, if you're British, which I at this point I kind of hope so, because like it would make more sense to reference Stephen Fry. English, okay. Yeah, Stephen Fry did a, I don't know what show he did it for, but he was actually going to college football games. Yeah, I love him on QI. Like, for as much shit as I think Americans get for our shitty television and stuff like that, I do love a lot of, there's a lot of, like, British, humorous British television that I love. But Stephen Fry did a thing for one of his shows where he went to, like, some of the big-time college football games and was just amazed, because he's just like, this isn't even professional. This is people at university that are playing, like, and it's 80,000 people packed into a stadium for university players. And they're treated like celebrities. I thought it was pretty funny just how amazed he was at, like, just the whole... Oh boy, I'm gonna get hit hard. Yeah, just the whole flair and everything that we have for our games.
From the 26-yard line, it's second down. He scrambled.
Oh, I should have passed it. He was open. Oh well. Bing bang. I'm wondering if he meant Big Bang. I'm assuming that. What gets me is the money on college teams and the players get none of it. Yeah. We'll say technically the players get none of it.
Now he's scrambling. There's a strike complete.
Tackle. I mean, yeah, for a bunch of state schools, yeah, they get a crap load of money, which has not done very well for a lot of the people that coach the teams, that are, you know, the stars of these teams. Like, it's treated like, with a lot of these people, they're treated like professional guys. Like, some of these college players are treated like celebrities themselves because they're good, and the coaches are treated like that as well. I think I live in Iowa, and I think the football coach for University of Iowa makes like,
he's scrambling.
Oh, I didn't even remember. Like, $5 million, something like that.
That wasn't intercepted. Not a very smart,
yeah, he's like one of the highest paid guys. He makes somewhere between like $3 to $5 million a year just to coach college football.
And they'll look to convert here on another
strike in the college league. I don't remember that. Was there an NCAA strike? Okay. Yeah, that. I don't know if that was a big thing. Yeah. Like, some of the highest paid guys are paid like $3 to $5 million to coach college football. Like I said, they treat this like professional, basically. Like, you'll have guys who are like rookies going into like the actual NFL professional football, that like are already extremely well known. Like, they already have like the money. Like, as soon as they can get to a professional team, they get that money. They have like the trademarks. Like, one of the rookie guys hasn't even proven himself in like the professional sense yet, and he's already got like all these huge endorsements and just all of that. Oh boy. We'll keep Willis in.
There hasn't been too much daylight.
But yeah, like, the schools make a crap load of money. If you ever look it up on Google, because like I said, like, money ends up corrupting people, especially in college football, because people have so much pride when it comes to their school, because like it's kind of like with pro football is a little bit different, where it's like, if you live in that area, like, most of the people that you'll encounter are like fans of that team that's in that general area. But you'll get a lot of guys that are fans of just like bigger teams. Oh, I got it. But with college football, it is a whole lot of like, you're dealing with like, it always feels more personal. So it's people that, like, are in the area, and they're extremely, like, proud of their guys. Yeah, $85 million a year. I don't even think we got anybody who does that. Like, in, like, $85 million. The most I've ever heard for a single player, I think, I was gonna think Alex Rodriguez, who is a guy who plays baseball for the New York Yankees. He does, like, $26 million. But I think Kobe Bryant actually makes more. I think he makes about $30 million. But on the other side, like, he's Kobe Bryant. Like, he's kind of like one of those world-renowned household names that's selling the tickets for, like, celebrities and all that. Like, Kobe Bryant for basketball, like, has done enough for basketball that, like, celebrities will buy season tickets to sit in the front row to watch his games. But, yeah, because of the money, if you ever look at it for anyone outside of the U.S. who wants to see something really screwed up, I think if you go Google Jerry Sandusky or Joe Paterno or just like Penn State scandal, Penn with two N's, yeah, or to be seen at his games, that's basically what it is. It's like having an Apple product. Like, it's all about just being seen with it, or like Beats headphones. It's all about just, like, the marketing of it. But, yeah, if you Google Penn State, you know, Penn with two N's, scandal, it was this whole thing about one of the guys, Jerry Sandusky, who runs the Penn State, like, football program. I think just the athletic program in general, but I think it's specifically the football program. And he was literally, like, molesting and raping young boys. I didn't mean to say, like, just anyone who has an Apple product is immediately, like, brainless, like, zombie that just believes everything marketing. Like, I understand how people have iPhones. But, yeah, like, Jerry Sandusky was in charge of it, and he was literally, like, raping and molesting young boys in, like, the showers of the, of their, like, football stadium and all that. And it went on for, like, legit 15 years. And basically, like, the head coach, Joe Paterno, knew about it. And he didn't really, he claimed to have told people, but, like, obviously not the police or anything like that. And people started coming forward and being like, yeah, this happened. And, like, as more and more people came in, like, obviously, Sandusky is in prison now. Paterno, I don't know if he's in prison.
Alex.
Huh? Oh, yeah, Paterno died. Yeah, I forgot about that. I didn't know if he was supposed to go to jail or not. I'm pretty sure he did, though. No? Okay. Well, it was a big enough thing that, it was a big enough thing that the 40, was it 40 years he was their head coach? It was like 40 years he was their head coach. If I had like an earlier version, I think I have an earlier version of the NCAA football game. But basically what he had is he had like the record for like most wins by a coach in a career and like most bowl game appearance, just a whole lot of career records. And it was just completely dashed from the record books. Like 40 years worth of him working for the school and all of that was completely erased from the record books. The dude had a statue built in his name because of how like ingrained into their football culture he was. They took that down. That's the most insane thing that I think has happened recently when it comes to money in sports. There's been some other stuff too. Like pro football, that's at least in college football. That's in college football. Pro football is way worse. Maybe not that bad, but it is a point where like people who like right now we got a couple of top stars who are not in football, like not playing right now.
From the 22-yard line.
Oh.
First down. And they've got the dime package in there to try and deal with this five receiver.
Yeah, we got a couple of guys that got in, like, trouble for,
at the 16-yard line.
Yeah, beating up their kids and their wives. I was trying to think what it's called. Domestic violence and domestic abuse, stuff like that. And the football, the NFL makes so much money that it's like, and the fact is those two guys were two of their biggest money makers when it came to like ticket sales and merchandise and like all that stuff. That like it's the like they're being considered like, oh yeah, they may be bad, like they're supposed to be gone like at least the entire season at the very least. And they're saying at least one of them could probably be back within the next, like, 4 weeks. By the way, I'm just destroying today. It's amazing.
He's been a force, getting a Bader three times. These guys are coming out firing on all cylinders. They've really taken control of this game early.
Drugs are big in the pro scene. I'd say so. Like, it's not as huge as it was. Like, it's way different in all different sports. Let's see. Football's never really had, like, a huge steroid scandal as far as I remember. Football's never really had, like, there are people who take it and they get caught and then they get, like, but there's never been, like, a huge thing where it's like, oh my god, all of these people are taking steroids and it's insane. Like, baseball's a little bit different. Baseball back in the 90s, with guys like, most notably, Sammy Sosa, Mark McGwire, and Barry Bonds. The mid to late 90s and even early 2000s were considered the steroid era in baseball. And it was just dudes who were just like cranking it out of the park. Oh boy. I shouldn't have taken that timeout. I wasn't even paying attention to the time. But yeah, like they broke home run records. All these guys broke all these home run records. Like for like 70 years, there was a, oh my god, I'm going to do it before halftime. Oh my god. No! Shit, he didn't make it. Damn it, and I can't call a timeout. Damn it, I shouldn't have called timeout. I would have had the timeout. Damn it. I'm not too worried, because it's... I'm ahead 31. Okay, now 31-13, but it's still 31-13. Like, they had the the home run record for a single season in baseball. It stood for like 60, 70 years. And then all of a sudden, these guys that eventually got busted for steroid use, it was like 52 home runs. And then like the first guy broke it, and then like it just kept going to a point where it's like, okay, 52, now 58, now 62, and like I think the record is now like 72 home runs a year. It's something ridiculous. Like 72 home runs a year is averaging like one every other game, which is just insanity. Because it's hard enough to get more than like one or two hits a game, and to know that like half of those are getting are like going out of the park. Watching Need for Speed videos. Thanks for the Need for Speed video stuff. I'd like to play more Need for Speed stuff, but that was mostly with like Jason and all them, and I'd assume. Like, I'm not 100% sure. I kind of assume that you maybe paid attention to DNR. That was mostly with, like, Jason and Justin and all them. And, you know, I don't really talk to them a whole lot right now. He's usually busy with his own stuff. Oh, boy. Oh, I thought I'd be able to get in the middle of it. I'm going to blow the lead is what's going to happen. So that's where the Need for Speed stuff. And Company Heroes, I do have Company Heroes. I could play Company Heroes. I mostly played it online, and I mostly just played it with friends was kind of the big thing. Because we kind of rolled off this honor system that, like, okay. Okay, cool. But, like, we kind of rolled off this honor system with Company Heroes, where it's like, okay, you can attack each other, but not, like, each other's base or anything like that. Like, just try to stay out of that and just try to take the territories. Well, most times in online, they don't have, like, an honor system like that because these people don't know each other, so they'll just go in and just destroy you. Like, they won't... It's not enough that they've taken, like, all the spots. It's a thing where they have to completely annihilate you.
Ball on their own 26.
And I've always never found that too amazingly fun. So if I find people to... Oh, boy. Please. Thank you. So if I find people, enough people to, like, play with that maybe can run off of a good honor system or something along those lines. Yeah, I suck at it too. I'm not great. What I am is I'm a good support person, because the general I like to play as is, like, the Tiger Ace one. And the reason I like the big Tiger Ace is because usually I'll play with somebody who's big on tanks, and they'll get a bunch of tanks out there. And I like the one towards the beginning where you can automatically, like, 3-star your guys and give them full experience. And I'll just take a whole bunch of full experience guys out there and just whip on people. Like, I'll have one guy take the tanks and everything, and I'll take out all the infantry.
Now we'll see how the backup can do after that injury.
So I greatly prefer being the... Oh, boy. I greatly prefer being the Germans, so I can do the Tiger Ace, and I can do that specific general, so I can just run with 4th and H. Did I go for it? Yeah, why not? So I can max experience my guys right out the gate.
He's gonna try and scramble.
Oh! Oh, he didn't make it!
Sometimes you get a bit greedy when you're not playing from behind.
Casey's,
and I think that's what happened here. In my mind,
I think someone got hurt too. We'll find out. And they made it. All right. I just gotta start, like, just bringing time off the clock.
They're ready to begin another drive.
If I'm distracting you, ignore me. No, I'm just... Like, what happened in the first half was I was facing a team that was playing much worse than the number 12 team in the nation. Because if you see the 12 next to the WVU, that means they're the number 12 team in the nation out of, I think, 126 teams. So I'm facing a pretty damn good team. And they weren't playing like a damn good team in the first half.
And we're back to the action.
Now they're starting to play the way they're supposed to be. Something, oh, Jesus. Yeah, see, like, there's nothing I can do about that. Like, if they just plow through my line, I can't do anything.
It's third down and 7 yards to go. Ball in the 29.
Oh, jeez.
He makes it to the 32-yard line.
He's making it, but he's just... Should I take a chance? I should really punt. I'll just let them punt. The more yards they have to go, the better. Ah, damn it. Okay, this is not good.
This is a pretty crucial series right here, with things being so tight. Your best players have...
I've always wanted to play Blood Bowl. I think I own it. I think it's one of those... Oh, God. Really? Is this a thing right now? Boy, they are just eating me alive at the line there.
From their own 20.
All right, I gotta try to pass this out.
They'll line up with 5 wide receivers.
Come on.
And he's immediately
all right, 2 yards.
What impresses me so much,
that's all I have to do.
The guy's vision.
Yeah, I think Blood Bowl is one of those games that I have in my library. Like, it's just in my vast backlog of games. I just never gotten around to it. There's a whole lot of games I want to play on live stream, and I just haven't gotten around to them yet. There we go.
And he carries the ball for a nice game. And they convert the first down on that run.
Who the hell is that? Is that their mascot? His mascots are usually like Cy the Cyclone walking around way back over there behind the end zone. It's usually like an animal or some big... Oh, my God. Some big character. And they just got this red beard dude.
just under three to go in regulation. Scrambling around.
Oh, he's so open. That wasn't even funny how open he was. Holy crap. That's cool, man. I think that's the first time my fullback has ever done anything. I'm gonna call him Coonskin Catman, just because I feel like Coonman has, God, they made it again. I feel like Coonman has some, negative racial tones to it.
He's at the 30. He's tackled around the 23 yard line. The Mountaineers will use their first time out of the half.
So just to be safe, I'm going to call him like Coonskin Catman. It's politically incorrect. I don't really mind. I'm not going to like sit here and be actively racist or anything like that. But
second of the half, O'Neal gained 7 yards on that play.
Just remember when I say Coon Man, it's because he's got the Coonskin cap. There's no. He's obviously a white guy, so there's nothing about it that.
He fights forward to about the 13. West Virginia will take their last time out.
Hushintosh. Yeah, otherwise I don't care.
So it's third down, and they're just inches away from picking up the first down.
There we go.
Tackle made at the 11-yard line.
First down. I think we've won this. We are now far enough away. We are now far enough towards the end zone. And it's now first down. We can just bury
just
some time off the clock here.
We're
just going to wait because we get about 18 seconds now until the play clock stops. And I'm going to pull some of that time off the clock because they've got zero timeouts. And we have got the win. There we go.
Brought down after a nice run up the middle.
That's a game 7 on the play.
Yep, this one is over.
Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down.
What was that guy at the Alamo with the coonskin? Oh, Davy Crockett, I think is his name. Yeah, Davy Crockett. Man, I can't remember my U.S. history most of this time. And touchdown.
O'Neal's play showing why he's a humble kid, and I'm sure he's going to give the credit to his offensive line.
Yeah, I can imagine you guys would learn about U.S. history in your class. Like that's a super. I feel like I don't know enough about British history. I barely know enough about like what British stuff that's been happening.
The Cyclones know that they have
like as far as history goes, like okay, there's the Queen and the Prince and Princess, and the Prince being born was a huge deal even over here. Except I think there was one guy from either like Channel 4 or BBC or something who said, there's gonna be a bunch of stuff coming from here, it's not gonna be news, something like that. I can't remember the name of the dude, but okay, military, yeah. I can't even remember who you guys' prime minister is. I don't know if it's still David Cameron or not. All right. Well, that was a fun game. That was a good way to end the season.